run out with this damn orangutan fur motherfucking chia pet ass poofy ass bra that we saw in the first episode. Bitch, we saw that already. It ain't new. It was ugly the first time we saw it. It's ugly now.
Uh-huh. Bitch, try again.
What's up, my name gang? Bitches, me. We're gonna do another review video to Bad Girl Club Season 17, Episode 5, Blindsided. Bitch, this season is so good. Like, this season is bomb. Just give me all the tea I needed. The fights is bopping, rocking, and stopping. Give me all the teas. Everybody flip flopping. Kiki smacking Sayori in the next episode. Like, bitch, when y'all just friends? Bitch, when y'all just friends? Can't none of y'all say that this season not entertaining? This season is so lit. So, get into the motherfucking review video, hoes. We start with the creature making peace with the house, saying that, oh, they don't, she don't want no more drama, and she don't want no more beef. Yeah, and still this bitch out here starting drama in a fucking couple more, in a cup, and not even an hour, bitch. How you want to stop the beef, but bitch, you start the motherfucking grinder up? How the fuck you want to start the beef, but you steady making meat patties? Like, what the fuck you doing? So they go to Venice Beach, and I noticed that the cars are still divided. Like, the girls who still fuck with each other strong went to the same cars. Like, I knew the shit wasn't gonna last when I saw that, because Key 7 and Shayla went into one car. And then, what the fuck, Sayora, Fran, Kiki went into another car. Ain't that bitch or whatever, and Kiki trying to save Fran from a fucking umbrella. Like, the umbrella just beating the fuck out of Fran. Kiki like, Fran, no, like, bitch, why you always fucking trying to come to this bitch rescue? Like, damn, you always up and away on this hoe. Every time Fran's in trouble, this bitch come fast as fuck. Bitch, you faster than the Jimmy John's, bitch. Soon as something happened, Fran, somebody's breathe Fran's name, bro, Kiki is there, ready to step the fuck up anything. Bitch, finna squat up with a fucking umbrella in this episode. I fuss with Kiki like that. I was like, if one of my bitches got into some shit, bitch, really, I'm gonna get, I got her back 100%. I fuss with the type of friend Kiki is, because she loyal as fuck. Like, I see, like, she a loyal ass friend. And her and the creature getting into it was just fucking stupid, because Kiki is, like, high-key a good ass person. But it's whatever. Seven and the creature decide to do a race across the fucking thing. Like, they did a little montage, like the lifeguarders. The creature ass looking big as fuck. Like, damn, girl. Bitch, you looking like 7 feet tall, 132 pounds. Like, bitch, you boom. Like, you big. She look like the sister from Lilo and Stitch. Like, that's exactly what I thought of when I saw her in there. She looked like the sister from Lilo and Stitch. Like, she had big thighs and, like, no boobs. But I'm not gonna lie, Kiki and Sam looked bomb at the motherfucking, the motherfucking beach. Like, Kiki, her, like, butt was all out. Like, she was fucking it up. It was a little mushy, like mashed potatoes, like we talked about before. Her shit was a little sloppy. I'ma give her kudos, her props. Seven was looking bomb though. Like, that my bitch. Like, I fucking love Seven, even though she was going crazy in the episode with Brie. But I love her. After they stopped racing or whatever, Seven and the creature start having a twerking like session, and everybody just get the twerking and shit. Even a fucking spitty bitch with a stick ass trying to twerk her back too. I'm like, yes, everybody just get it. Like, they was just all having fun. I was really fucking with, like, the whole kumbaya this episode, how everybody was trying to get along. And I was like, okay, we can get an episode where y'all was actually fucking with each other. But, like, as I knew, the shit wasn't gonna last the whole episode. Like, bitch, I knew that. Like, bitch, y'all at the beach, everybody has fun at the beach. It ain't that fucking serious. So later, after they go to the beach or whatever, they go to the club. And then they go to, like, drinks or have whatever. And Sayora as picking up somebody motherfucking grandpa, like we talked about before. Motherfucking wheelchair and senior citizens around and shit. Like, Sayora, girl, what you doing? You pretty as fuck. Like, you foreign and everything. You up here with musty ass, dusty ass, hanky panky in this bitch. He probably snuck out of a retirement home, was trying to go to the bar and pick up some young ass girls. And that's exactly what the fuck he did. Cause your dumb ass was going. Kiki said, we take care of the elderly. We do not have sex with the elderly. Yes, bitch. That nigga was like 75. Rick was all down his shit. And you over here, Kiki, cooling with him at the bar. Nigga needs to be somewhere taking his motherfucking medicine. Nigga needs someone taking the motherfucking blood pressure, making sure his shit ain't flustered. Like, damn. Sayora, what the fuck is you doing with your life? And then after her, she was just like, he's my mom's age. And she was just saying, like, we gonna see where this go. Bitch, it shouldn't go nowhere. Alright, this shit gonna lead to motherfucking life retirement checks and motherfucking hospital visits. That's what the fuck it's gonna lead to. So they get back from the beach or whatever, and Seven and Speedy Bitch have new bucket list, like, tasks. So Seven gotta go meet with a DJ, and Speedy Bitch gotta go sell her fucking bitch. whatever the fuck that was. But you gonna get to him when we get to it, bitch. Y'all know I had to drag Speedy Bitch for this because you already know I don't like Speedy Bitch. Never gonna like Speedy Bitch or the motherfucking creature. They asses together. Don't like neither one of them. But you know, when we get to that point, I'ma drag the bitch because she deserves to get her ass dragged. Just to show how irrelevant Speedy Bitch is, they in the house trying to figure out who the fuck like fast. They like, why is it a seamstress meeting on the fucking bucket list? Who likes seamstress? And then Speedy Bitch like, me, that's my task. Bitch, don't nobody even know that you up in here for fashion because you look a hot ass mess most of the time. Like, how you up in here trying to be fashion? You went to fucking 7 DJ studio thing looking like a fucking man. What the fuck with that poof thing on top of your head? Like, why you always got some poof shit up on you? Like the damn Amazonian jungle, bitch. Like, what you doing? Stop killing animals, bitch. Damn. Boy, your ass, I already like a fucking raccoon. Seven and Sayori go to the nail salon. I really thought it was nice how, like, they... when it has their own little segment, because like if you look at it, say in several don't talk in the house, like I never like see them conversating, like having like cuckoo kiki, like how you been, shit like this. So I like how they went to the nail salon, whatever, and it was like she hopes the new girl is cool. Say talking about she hope that she on the side and shit like that. And then Seven was like, I don't have no problem with her unless she's rub me the wrong way or do something I don't like and I'm gonna say something. I like how Seven is like, bitch, we cool until you start getting crazy. Like, we cool until you give me a reason to smack the fuck out of your face. So after all this, Seven, Speedy Bitch, and the creature go to Seven DJ class or whatever. And he got overalls on and a snapback. And I thought that was kind of cute. Like, it was a cute little hood Compton, like, kind of stylish thing. Like, that bitch really did not look a hot mess. That specifically. That motherfucking specific time in the Beggar's Clubhouse. I was fucking with her, like, with her dope, like, throwback clothes that she had on. Like, she looking better than DeShayla, the so-called fashionista of the motherfucking house. That all look a hot ass mess, like fucking squirrel all the time. Bitch looking for her nuts 24/7. Bitch, I'ma keep dragging her, bitch. I'ma drag her this whole episode. So if you like DeShayla and you get upset and flustered that I'm talking about the spittiest bitch in the house, then you might as well cut this video right now, because as soon as this bitch fashion shit come out, she getting it. She gonna get it. Soon as they get there, the man asks Seven, like, have you ever DJed before? And he's like, she like, nah, but I'm bomb as fuck with the Oscar. And I'm like, yes! Like, yes, Seven bitch asked me, like, bitch, I haven't DJed before, but when that Oscar slide into my phone, bitch, no fire coming the fuck back out. When that Oscar slide into my phone, no that fire coming the fuck back out. I fucks with Seven so fucking much, cause he's like, bitch, I ain't DJed before, but give me that motherfucking Oscar and I'll make your whole life flip and turn for the better, bitch. Alright, bitch. Fuck it up, Seven. Girl, you better fuck it up for yourself. They at the little turntables or whatever, and they like wiki-wiki and all that stupid shit. And Speedy Bitch got on 3 different motherfucking colors. Bitch got on a light blue hat. I think it was like orange or red shirt. I don't remember exactly, but it wasn't correct. An orange or a red shirt and some motherfucking dark blue pants. Like, girl, how is you a fashionista or whatever and your ass looking a mess? On TV, in front of everybody. They go through Seven DJ class and she's talking about how dope it is and like she like, I don't know how the fuck it sound, but I'm just happy that I'm doing it. I'm like, yes, Seven, you better fuck that shit up. Like, do what you do, girl. Do what you do. You got goals, bitch. Achieve them. So they go back to the house and it's time for Speedy Bitch to do her sewing seamstress thing or whatever. And the creature hook her up with one of her friends, one of her creature friends, and they get with the Speedy Bitches. They trying to collab so she can actually like do something with her life. I thought that was really nice of the creature to like help her out, because the bitch is like, she needs help, like she look a mess 24/7. So I was like, yes, the creature, you better help the Speedy homeless bitch, help her out. Matter of fact, take some of her clothes away. They was like, the person that Speedy Bitch is hooking up with designs most of the creature clothes. And I was like, why the fuck would you want to work with them? All tea, all shade, bitch. Okay. So later that night, they're about to go to the club or whatever, and the creature buys a necklace from Kiki, and she like, I need a head chain, and then Kiki like, I got this necklace, but it'll use it as a head chain. The creature was like, yeah, bitch, I'm gonna just smack that shit on my head and think I look cute, which she didn't. They at the club or whatever, and then like they dancing, and then Sayora friends come, and they all having a ball, and guess who motherfucking man? The Grinch herself, the motherfucking stale weave monster tracks Grinch herself, just always upset. Always, man. Like, every time Sayora pulling at least one dude, she mad. But now it's Kiki pulling dudes, twerking on somebody. I think Fran was twerking on somebody. Like, damn. Everybody getting attention except her. Obviously, her ass was gonna get salty. Like, as soon as I saw them start twerking, I knew before they even went to this bitch grudge-ass face that she was gonna be mad. I felt the madness before they even turned the fucking camera frame. So they get back into the limo or whatever, and Seven tell the creature that you should not be letting these bitches, like, get to you that much. Like, you should not be always, like, letting shit get to you. And I'm like, yes, Seven. Like, you need to have a talk with this bitch. Like, y'all be sitting down trying to have talks with a creature. I was trying to sit there and have talks with bitches and try to tell them about their life. Tell this bitch about her life. Ain't none of y'all hoes her friend because all her shit all fucked up. She go outside looking a mess, come in the house looking a mess, go to sleep looking a mess. Like, if that's your real friend, help her. Help the bitch. Please. Tell her she always getting the hot and heated over the dumbest shit. Bitch was mad at first episode over Rice and Roni. That bitch, what you mad for Rice and Roni for? Let me stop, because, bitch, I'd be mad as fuck up with some Rice and Roni, too. And I don't even like Rice and Roni, bitch. But I would still get mad if you touch my shit. She said they look thirsty because dudes was coming in a section. I'm like, how the fuck y'all look thirsty? You just dancing in a fucking club. Yo ass is thirsty and mad because nobody wants your fucking back bouncing. Your motherfucking mashed potato sacks bouncing up on their shit. Like, you just, I hate her. I fucking hate her, like, 24-7, all the damn time. Like, damn, you don't ever get stop hating. Like, you never get tired of hating. Bitch, you can't take a breath and not be weak, bitch. Like, in that one breath, can you just stop being a whack-ass bitch and just fix your demeanor? The creature got an attitude in the limo, and they all, like, why the fuck... No, she was like, why the fuck does my attitude affect... Why the fuck does my attitude affect y'all so much? Bitch, this is the Bad Girls Clubhouse, bitch. I see you every fucking day. If every fucking day I see your ass and you all balled the fuck up in your face, that shit gonna get irritating after a while. If every motherfucking day I see your ass with this damn lizard shit on top of your head looking a hot ass mess, that shit gonna get irritating after a while. If every motherfucking day I see you in the house with these black ass elbows and these ashy ass kneecaps, bitch is gonna get irritating after a while. Don't try to say why does my shit affect everybody else. Bitch, it obviously will because I see you every day. Are you dumb? The creature getting hot and bothered for no reason. And she called Kiki a bitch and like throw her head chain to her and she calling her fat. And I'm like, bitch, you gonna throw her fat? Like, okay, so if she fat, fuck me. Kiki is pretty as fuck to be fat. Like, don't call a bitch fat if she winning. Like, Kiki ain't ugly. You can't call her ugly, but we can all call your ass ugly. That's what Kiki should have said. I'm fat, but bitch, you ugly. All right, if I want to, I can go to the gym and stair climbing this bitch for a couple years. And my shit'll be flat. Like, Kiki, she getting skinny now, actually. To put that in motherfucking context, Kiki is getting skinnier now. Bitch, your face still fucked up forever. All right, so any shit you can do. Yes, Kiki can be fat, but she ain't that fat no more. But guess who's still fucked up, though? Okay. Alright, I was just making sure. They get the arguing of Kiki tried. She tried to run up on the creature and she snatched her purse and it broke. So I was like, damn, that bitch must have busted me on the fucking cheap because it wasn't even like a hard of a snatch. She just broke that bitch. And the creature got kicked off the limo, so it was whatever. I was tired of seeing that bitch weeping. Say, Aura, in her confessional, whatever, she like how Kiki is a hypocrite and how she preaches about living your life and not letting bitches get to you and always being about your hustle and I don't want no drama. Yo ass always trying to fight bitches and start drama for no fucking reason. Okay, you mad. If you was mad about the thing, you didn't have to get in the limo and say nothing. You could have just sat to the side and be quiet and just be like, okay, I'm mad, whatever. I'm not gonna start a problem because we already got peace in the house. But no, this bitch started a whole hoopla because her creature ass is mad all the fucking time. And now everybody like, back at each other's throat. So if anybody can say that somebody was stirring a pot or making beef in the house, it's fucking the creature, not Kiki, the creature. They get back home and my new bitch Bree picture is up. Bitch, I love me some Bree. You know why I love me some Bree? Cause that bitch ghetto as fuck. Like, I gotta always fuck with my ghetto bitches. Like, the creature, she ghetto, but she like that bad ghetto. Like, she the ghetto that like, she like, can I get a dollar ghetto? Like, Bree, she out here making money, but bitch, I will smack your face ghetto. Like, I'm a bougie bitch, but don't take me there ghetto. Like, she like me and be like, bitch, we coolin', bitch. If you give me a check, bitch, I'm not finna go off on you. I'm finna curse you out, bitch. We coolin', bitch. You sign on fucking check, bitch. I'm alright. But if you try me, bitch, it's another story. Like, that's how Bree is. She about her money. She about doing her thing. But if you fuck with a bitch, she'll fuck you up. And I love that bitch. So they talking about Bree picture, whatever. And Fran feeling some type of way because she blonde. And she like, I'm the first Barbie in this house. And this. I was like, Fran, girl, you ain't got to do all that. Like, I fuss with Fran. But like, this whole Barbie situation, I'm feeling like somebody gonna replace you. Then you shouldn't have had that thing in your head. I don't feel like no bitch can replace me. The fuck I look like being replaced by another bitch. All right, bitch, we both blonde. But guess what? I'm the baddest blonde bitch in this bitch. bitch at the end of the day. And I'm the original first blonde bitch in this bitch at the end of the day. So I'm not finna let no bitch try to take my shine away from me. That's exactly how Fran should have been. She shouldn't have been, oh, I don't want her to replace me. I was the first blonde girl. And I don't want her to be better than me. She looked like she was intimidated by her being at, like, coming to the house. Like, she was like, oh, she gonna take the spotlight and she gonna be better. Like, don't let nobody have you out here looking like that, bitch. I'm blonde too. You blonde, but I'm the better blonde. Fuck, you thought this was. Okay, bitch, my lighting is six. I mean, like, it wasn't all cute and all together like usually was at first, but it's gonna get there at some point, alright? No, bear with me, alright? I bitch was dumb. I was wondering why my shit was so dark, but it wasn't just because I'm dark as fuck. It was just because the fucking light wasn't on. Back at it again with some better ass lighting. Key come back to the house and she like, they talking about, oh, look at the new girl, look at the new girl. She like, I don't give a fuck about the new girl replacement, bitch. This bitch needs to get replaced. And she just walked past Kiki like Kiki wasn't gonna say shit. And Kiki was like, who needs to get replaced? Replace me, bitch. She started going off on the creature and she like, you ain't gonna ever replace me. She said, I'd be damned if I let a bitch like you push me out this house. Girl, swerve. I was like, Kiki better tell this creature, manly ass, fucked up face ass, plug face ass bitch, that she ain't let nobody, she ain't pushing nobody out this fucking house. Bitch, you couldn't even push Sayora out this fucking house. And Sayora got her shit smacked the fuck up, man. Guess what? Her ass still there and pretty as fuck. Girl, swerve, bitch. You ain't even about the action. I was. Kiki, you better slay. Like, you better get that bitch. Show that motherfucking creature ass bitch that she ain't about the fucking action. She said, girl, swerve. Fuck you thought this was. After that, Kiki run up and all hell breaks loose. I mean, they arguing, security grabbing these bitches. Like, Kiki trying to run and get the creature. And the creature over there look at a hot ass nothing fucking corner. Like, like Kiki really trying to get this bitch. Like, she get her. Then they get separated and then Kiki like, you so negative, you a negative Nancy, and you can't never stop problems in the house because you always gonna be like that. And then they separated and then the creature decided to say, oh, your mama the devil, bitch, and like try to comfort her. And she even know that she said specifically, don't say shit about my mama and I won't say shit about your brother because that is a respectful level. And you gonna go low blow and cheap shot this bitch because you upset. Like, that was fucked up. If you're friends with somebody and then y'all stop being friends, you go and telling all their fucking business and doing shit that you know that's gonna really fuck with them, that's just fucked up, like, for real. Kiki come in the room mad as fuck because the creature talked about her mama. She get the rant to say, you're knocked the fuck out. She, this bitch always talking is this shit ain't never gonna stop. I'm tired of it, rah rah. And fucking say, or F. She was not paying no attention. This bitch knocked the fuck out. This bitch ranting to her ass sleep. Kiki like, say, or wake up. What are you doing? It's about the fight this bitch and you up here asleep. Like, that shit was so fucking funny because like she was talking to her ass was knocked the fuck out, like not listening. So after all this happened, they start talking about the new girl and the creature said how she wanna use the new girl to shake shit up in the house, so she won't have to get her hands dirty and she wanna be manipulative, so they're gonna try to be friends with her. I'm like, girl, you ain't smart enough to bitch, you can't even get your fucking lace front together. How the fuck you trying to manipulate a bitch? Manipulate that sewing. How about that? So they all go to sleep and the next morning my bitch Bree hit the scene with the motherfucking gasoline with the OxyClean in this bitch. Bree is from Las Vegas. She a stripper. So in her like casting tape, whatever, it was like a pantry. She said, you already know ain't shit in here in my pantry. Your daddy takes me out, so I don't need too much. Yes, bitch, but get that coin. Like, she was like, bitch, your daddy takes me out. I don't need to get no food at my house, bitch. If I needed something, I'll get your nigga to take me out to eat. And then she talked about how it was interesting because she was like, I used to be fat. And I used to have, like problems with my confidence. And, like, now she, like, slim. She like Kiki. How Kiki gonna be, like, Kiki gonna be fat as fuck. And then she gonna be, like, she gonna, like, slim her shit down, get her shit together, whatever. But I feel like some bitches don't, not everybody gotta always just become skinny. Like, I feel like Kiki gonna look like Tanisha. Tanisha was cute as fuck when she was big. Well, who else looked cute as fuck when they was big? What the fuck is that bitch name? The girl from Identity Thief. What the fuck is her bitch name? I forgot, but her picture is right there probably. But she looked cuter when she was big and now she all skinny. I'm like, damn, she ain't gonna be as funny no more because she ain't big. Like, I just don't think everybody should slim down to become skinny just cause that's what it's supposed to be. Like, that's what you supposed to be, society said you should be. No, bitch, be a big bitch. Fuck that shit. I eat and I eat you. Fuck. Bree come in the house screaming, wake up, bitches, I'm here, right? album. Yes, bitch. Wait, these hoes out. Let these bitches know. Let these bitches know. She throwing dollars and shit in their room, cutting on lights and shit, bitch. Rise and shine, fuck you, me. I'm the alarm clock in this bitch. Yes, bitch. I'm the motherfucking alarm clock, bitch. Everybody need to be in the classroom. Tired and sleepy as fuck, and I'm be the only bitch hollering. It's trying to turn the fuck up. Fuck you, thought this was. But she throwing dollars and shit on people, telling them to get the fuck up. Like, she doing a lot. Like, I fuck with Bree. I fuck with Bree so much. So, she and this bitch throwing money at fucking Kiki ass. Hit a motherfucking speed rusher, funeral out of motherfucking bed, start snatching dollars and shit. I mean, she. Like, picking up money, like, it ain't nothing. Like, she ain't had no shame, bitch. She me, bitch. You wanna throw dollars, bitch? I'm picking them bitches up. Fuck you talking about? This gonna buy me a McChicken or something. Fran was like, is she serious? She like this. She like, just remember, I was the first Barbie in this house in her confession. I'm like, okay, Fran, girl, I just really hope y'all don't get into it. Just because, bitch, y'all got blonde hair. Like, that's the dumbest shit to fight over. Why the fuck you fight her? Because her hair was blonde. Bitch, okay. So, Bree in the house or whatever, and they all like, walking around, she talking and like she like talking to everybody, and then the creature was laying down next to Speedy bitch. So I don't know what the fuck that bed had to smell like old ass clap and like fucking old armpits and shit. But they was laying next to each other, and the creature got up like, okay, I'm up, and she just hopped up. And who the fuck get up next? Speedy bitch. Oh, I'm up too. Bitch, your ass. Bitch was in a. I'm up too. Your ass a follower, like. We're gonna get to it later because I'm not even gonna talk about it right now, but we're gonna get to it when we get to it. After they get up, Bree, Seven, and Speedy Bitch on the rooftop with the creature. And the creature spitting game to Bree, telling her about like what happened in the house and the drama and what's going on. The creature talking about how she beat up Sayora twice. I'm like, girl, you is still gloating about beating this girl up. This bitch has like 3 episodes ago. Beat her up again. Like, beat her up for real, to a point where we be like, damn, that bitch really got her ass beat. Like, how Bree about to beat the fuck out of Fran, we could be like, damn, that bitch really got her ass beat. Like, beat her up like that, and then we can actually say you beat her ass. You didn't beat her up. You didn't. You slapped her a couple times, y'all started spinning, we was Gucci. Speedy bitch telling, like, oh, she fought the fat girl, I fought the blonde, and she fought the girl with the tattoos. I'm like, but you ain't telling who won, though, because everybody else won their fights except you. You talking about who fought. Who the fuck was winning them bitches? The creature didn't even win her fight because it wasn't a motherfucking fight. Seven won her fight. I'm going to say she won because everybody in the motherfucking comments was like, she won her fight! So I had to go back and do some research about what the fuck happened in the fight. And I put that bitch in slow motion and every motherfucking thing. Seven ass was connecting better punches. Key ass was swinging, but her ass wasn't connecting punches. But Seven was just like, booping. I get you. 7-1, stop coming for me in the fucking comments. Alright? I understand. I learned my lesson, alright? Leave me alone. Speedy bitch was trying to like say like how we fighting all these girls, but bitch, you lost. Like, the difference between everybody else fight, you didn't win. Like, bitch was trying to tell, oh, I fought her. Bitch, did you win? No, you didn't. So how about you just add that until when you trying to talk about what the fuck happened? You can't tell half the story without telling the whole story. Yes, you fought her, but you got your ass slammed on the ground and wailed on. Don't try to, bitch, don't stop. Please, Speedy bitch, girl, I'm already starting to drag you in this fucking episode. Bitch, I ain't even gave you all the gifts to how hard I'm gonna drag your ass today. And then Bree was like, bitch, I can already tell what the fuck she doing. She trying to get me on her side, but guess what, bitch, I don't pick sides. Fuck you thought this was, bitch, I decide for my own. I'll have no beef with nobody until they cross me. And I'm like, yes, bitch, be a real bitch. Have your own brain. Don't let no bitches manipulate you into looking dumb on TV because your stupid ass out here like, oh, she said she don't like her. Well, I'm gonna have to watch that bitch. Like, no, get your own opinion. I love how Bree came and she got her own fucking opinion. She fought whoever the fuck she wanted to fight because they came across her. Bree telling the girls about like her sugar daddy and how she a stripper and how she Barbie from the block. And I'm like, yes, bitch, I love what she said, bitch. I'm Barbie from the block. I might be ha ha hee hee, but bitch, I'm still hood as fuck. So here we are. It's time. We're at Spitty Bitches meeting. I'ma just scoot up right now just so I have to don't in the future, because like this whole thing in general was just, oh no. But okay, I'm coming bitch. Wait, just wait on me because I'm coming. Alright, I'm here all in your face so we can talk about this dumb girl. This bitch she comes to the motherfucking meeting looking a hot ass mess. First of all, how you come to a fashion meeting looking a mess? What the fuck is wrong with you? This is a meeting. This is a motherfucking invite. This is a motherfucking professional setting. You ask out here coming, looking like somebody motherfucking raccoon ass uncle. Hi, auntie. Bitch, you don't even get your sex. You like somebody uncle. Bitch, look. So they going through the meeting, whatever. So I'm trying my best to like not drag her. Like, okay, I'm gonna be like, she doing good with her fashion. Like, I'm gonna be like, in my review video, I'm not gonna drag her today because she doing good. So it was all up and nice and handy dandy. So this bitch put out this motherfucking pelican feather ass shoes, bitch. Motherfucking bitch, you got them feathers from the arts and crafts store and just glued them bitches on some regular shoes. You didn't make that shit, bitch. You didn't make that. You took some regular shoes and glued some motherfucking feathers on them. And I think with some cute feathers, like them like motherfucking feathers that be on them little necklace things. Like, you know, when they put feathers on shoes, they put like high fashion feathers. Like some shit that be actually cute. This shit look like some fucking melted Starburst that just smacked that shit on the shoe. It wasn't cute. It wasn't motherfucking cute. She needs to just stop. Alright, fashion ain't for you, just like rapping ain't for the fucking creature. After she put out the motherfucking parakeet stompers, she come out with this damn orangutan fur motherfucking chia pet ass poofy ass bra that we saw in the first episode. Bitch, we saw that already. It ain't new. It was ugly the first time we saw it. It's ugly now. Bitch, I need to breathe. This bitch saw a motherfucking possum titty bra and think that shit was just okay. Like, why would you do that? Even everybody in the motherfucking meeting just looking at her like, the lady was like, oh, this is interesting. Like, that shit was ugly. It was ugly. Should've brought that shit out. You embarrassed me. Bitch, I would've just got up and left if I was a creature or something. This got me all the way up out here. This is motherfucking factory where they making good, nice ass clothes. They got Macy's and shit. Which is gonna bring out this damn arts and crafts ass clap that fucking 2-year-old could've did. What the fuck? I would've left your dumb ass there looking stupid. I would've just left. All together. Why would you bring me here with that shit? After, it was so funny because the lady didn't even say it looked nice. She didn't compliment her. She was like, oh, this is interesting. I've never seen any fashion before like this. Obviously, you ain't seen no fucking fashion before like this. You didn't catch the hint, Spady bitch. She said she didn't see the fashion before like this because that shit was ugly. Ugly. She didn't see no fashion before like that because your shit was a mess. Nobody in a right man would make that dumb shit and put it in on their body. It's not happening. Bitch, you gotta be either high or stupid like Kiaria. Or what, like the fucking creature. This was just a mess. It was just a fucking mess. And then she started giving her tips about what she needs to do with her life. And I couldn't be her. Because they always, all these motherfucking people at like the fucking creature studio session. And now at Speedy Bitch motherfucking shit. Like the only person who actually did good at that shit was Fran and Seven. Those are the only people actually I can see them achieving their goals. These bitches getting bitches brownie points from bitches that get paid to say that you did it good. And then one bitch start crying over studio time. It's studio time. What the fuck? I'ma scoot back. I'ma just scoot the fuck back just because I'ma lose my voice if I keep on hollering. But, bitch, don't do that shit no more. You better not do that shit no more. If I ever go to the store and I see motherfucking Speedy Bitch Express on the damn racks, I'm lighting that shit on fire. Because it don't deserve to live. It don't deserve to motherfucking live. So later that night, they go to the motherfucking strip club or whatever. He going around asking people for tips and money on like to turn to singles so they could throw it on the strippers and stuff. And she mad because Frank only gave her $15 and Sayora only gave her $20. Like, bitch, is that your money? Why the fuck? Maybe the bitch is trying to cut back. Like, bitch, I'm not finna be out here just throwing all my money on a bitch booty cheeks. Maybe they saving their money for something else, bitch. Y'all got a whole Las Vegas trip coming up. And you think bitches is gonna have money to blow like this? No, bitch. She pressed about somebody else's money. Bitch, worry about your money. Worry about your weave. Alright? She would've asked me, why you ain't giving her money? Okay, why the fuck your weave like that? The fuck? Next morning, the creature still talking about the same shit that happened last night just to start a fucking problem. You can't just let shit go and just be like, okay, they didn't want to pay it, whatever, I'm over it. She gotta keep talking about it. Literally, I bet this bitch was in the limo talking about it. Everybody just like this bitch not gonna shut up. Like, they didn't even show no limo scene because I bet everybody was in there bitch like, oh my god, shut the fuck up. Because she probably had something to say about it. She's talking about it, whatever, and keep coming up and she like, if you got anything to say, bitch, say it to my face. Like, I'm in this house with you. I feel like you being indirect towards me, so what the fuck you got to say? And then She like, ride, and that's when the creature bring up Kiki Mama again. Like, stop low blowing this bitch Mama. Like, honestly, like, talking about my mama is the quickest way to get your face smacked the fuck off. You don't say shit about my mama because my mama ain't say shit about you. At the end of the day, my mama can shit on your mama twice. Fuck you thought this was. They argue whatever, and then the creature like, if you don't want to fight, then shut up. Like, what's up? Like, you trying to fight, what's up? And then Kiki like, what the fuck you mean trying to fight? You don't want the issues, though, so you fight me. Like, what the fuck you talking about? Kiki start going in on her, calling her ass a loser. How she ain't, like, she ain't got no flow on of that what she said, but that's all I heard. That's all I hope she would say, because that's the quickest way. She want to throw cheap shots. So I throw cheap shots on this bitch motherfucking country western accent, because the bitch ain't got no bars. Bitch, you ain't even got toothpicks, let alone a damn bar. Next morning, Sarah tell Bree what's up in the house on the rooftop, and how they stopped fucking Kiki just because Kiki started fucking with Sayori, and how the whole house is how the creature wanted the whole house to flop and flip on and go against Sayori. So when Kiki started fucking with her, that's when everybody started fucking with Kiki. Priest said that Seven and Speedy Bitch is like minions because they be following the creature. And I'm like, okay, I'ma say Speedy Bitch is definitely a follower, but Seven can't do that. Seven definitely ain't a motherfucking follower. I'm gonna put that shit on everything. And she even got mad later after I'm talking about that shit too, because she said that she was a follower. And if a bitch ever tell me, oh, you following this bitch, I'm gonna instantly get mad. Like, bitch, I ain't following no motherfucking body. Jalen gonna do Jalen regardless. I feel where Seven was coming from when she was like, bitch, I was following you, because who the fuck am I following? Don't ever call me a fucking follower. The fuck I look like? So yeah, I just had to clear it up real quick. Well, if we get to the motherfucking topic, I had to clear it up. Retail Sayori that they tried to start shit between her and Fran. I'm like, yes, bitch, clear the fucking air before we get to this stupid shit. But y'all hoes gonna fight anyway. So, like, when they were just clearing it out, I was like, okay, this shit is stupid because y'all hoes gonna fight in the first place. So I'm not finna sit here and listen to y'all kumbaya when I know bitches finna be throwing them bitches in a couple of episodes. Like, I don't give a fuck. Bree and Fran clear the air and settle things about how Fran felt, and I feel like Fran was hella mature. How she like worded what she said, like, a person with features as of yourself, you would be also like threatened to like them to take your shine or whatever, or like be in competition. And I was like, yes, Fran, like, she was mature as fuck about it. Like, she ain't come at her like, well, I feel like just because you was blind and you was trying to like be better than me, like, she was just telling her like what was up. And I was like, yes, Fran, like, be a mature ass real bitch. Like, you can't be a petty bitch 24/7. Like, I'm a petty bitch, like, I'm going to say 20, I'm going to say 22, 21, because I ain't 24, but I'm at least like 21, 22. But I'm going to work on my shit, right, bitch? I'm growing. Just like everybody else growing, bitch, I got to grow too. After this, or whatever, the creature go and meet up with her mama, and they talk about, like, what happened in the house, because it's her sister's 18th birthday or whatever. I didn't give a fuck. Only thing I was worried about is how the creature mama weave looked, because if your daughter weave fucked up, then your mama weave had to fuck up, because the mama is supposed to teach the daughter what the fuck to do and how to be a girl and shit like this. If your mama weave fucked up, then that's probably the reason why the creature weave fucked up. As soon as she told me she was gonna meet her mama, I'm like, I wanna know how did the bitch weave look. And as predicted, her shit was a mess too. So, over that, back at home, Bree tells the girls to be quiet because they was in there sleeping up whatever. And then he starts stomping. The fuck you stomping for? Bitch, if I tell you I'm trying to be quiet, I'm trying to be sleep, can you please be quiet and your ass starts stomping? Bitch, your ass is a mess. Like, that was hella petty. Bitch, I'm just trying to go to sleep. Leave me the fuck alone. Can you please stop being loud? And that's all Bree said, and then this bitch wanna start stomping. Like, I was hella happy when Bree got the fuck up and told these bitches, like, don't be fucking stomping. Why a bitch trying to catch some Z's? Cause if you wanna start stomp, why a bitch trying to catch some Z's? Any one of y'all hoes can get some motherfucking hands. If I don't catch no Z's, bitches gonna start catching hands. That's what exactly what she should have told them bitches. I ain't gonna catch no Z's, y'all gonna catch some hands. Bree go into the girls' room to talk to them about who was thumping, and Kiki instantly in the background putting her hair up. Like, I love how the ride or die type of friend Kiki is. Like, if my bitch finna go in there with three bitches by herself, best believe I'm gonna be at the door waiting for any bitch to pop the fuck out. Cause you don't know what the fuck they might try to do or who try to fight them. So Kiki is like a damn ass bitch. I fucking love her. Okay, she got her ass beat. Okay, she got slammed a couple times. But at the end of the day, Kiki is a real ass bitch. And can't nobody say Kiki ain't a real ass bitch. Like, she a good ass friend. She protective of her friends. She fight for her bitches and she run shit for her bitches. And that's a good ass bitch at the end of the day. Like, I always need a bitch like that always right hands with me. So if I'm going through my day, I always do, like, if I ever got jumped, my bitch got my back. They get to talking or whatever, and Bree like, you know you leave this shit around here, so you just need to tell your girls to be quiet. And then Seven instantly hit up. She only shit around like 7 and instantly came about her seat, came about her dream and was like, this bitch really just say that this bitch run me? Like, she don't run shit up around here. And then she was trying to tell her, and then Bree was like, oh, well, I'm not talking to you, I'm talking to her, and she like this. And then she was like, I'm just saying, I just said, as a woman, just don't make a lot of noise. And she was like, I know I'm gonna smoke a cigarette. And then, and she like high key treat the fuck out of the creature, like had her ass shut the fuck up and walk away, like, I'm gonna go smoke a cigarette. Don't talk no more, bitch, I'm finished. I was, put that motherfucker moves to her place. So they on the rooftop or whatever. I think it was Kiki and Bree. And Seven come up and talk to her about what she said in the room. Cause I was like, Seven, girl, you better go say that. Say something to her. Like, she just called you a whole follower. I'm not gonna let nobody call me a fucking follower and just not say nothing. So as I love, she went up there and said something to her ass, like, who the fuck a follower? And she like telling her off, like, she don't follow nobody. She definitely don't follow. Like, she was like, I don't follow nobody. She definitely like don't leave me and shit like this. They were like, I don't know what y'all telling her, but I'm not following nobody. And I was like, I didn't like that because like Kiki didn't tell her shit. That's just what Bree was observing. She just felt like you was following her. That's what she said. So I don't like how she put Kiki in it as if Kiki was talking shit behind Seven back. I didn't like that because like you just made an assumption that she was talking shit when Kiki said nothing about them being a follower. Oh well, that's why we said boys. That's what we saw, but she, as we've seen, she didn't say shit about them being a follower. So, especially Seven, why the fuck would? Well, yeah, they fall. Oh yeah, okay. I understand. So Seven explained to Bree how she not a follower and shit, and then she like, but you hikey. She like, you Loki came for me, and then Bree was like, if I came for you, you would know I was coming for you. She said, if I came for you, you would know I was coming for you. She told that bitch multiple times, if I came for you, you would know I was coming for you, bitch. Don't ever try to say I come for you, because bitch, if I was coming for you, bitch, your ass would be on the floor. If I was coming to you, bitch, your ass would be bleeding. If I come for you, bitch, your ass would have some lumps, some knots, some boops, some bands. Bitch, if I was coming to you, ho, you would know I was coming for you. So don't try to say, oh, I was coming for you, because bitch, if I was, you would know. You would motherfucking know. Like, let me just sit real quick, because, like, a bitch is tired, and y'all already. Ooh, bitch, I thought this motherfucker juice was about to get on my pants. I'm finna cry. Bitch, I already know a bitch. I always say with the motherfucking juice. Y'all don't even know, bitch, be taking sips between cuss. Like, y'all don't even know this what the fuck I be doing. I get all this energy right here, bitch. Jumex. Sponsor, bitch. Oh, hell yeah. Oh, hell yeah. Oh, hell yeah, juice, bitch. Oh, yes! I got juice! Let's fuck it up even more! Oh, fuck, the episode over. Damn, I can't even get crazy in this bitch. Oh, no, we still got the motherfucking preview. Three, after they get the argument of a Seven walk away, like, bitch, in this house got me fucked up. And they walk away and bring on her confessional. And she, like, as soon as you do something I don't like, she said, and boom, and I was like, bitch, that's me, because if y'all don't know, my nails grow like hella long. Like in my past videos, obviously I cut them because I actually had to scrape. I confronted a bitch at school recently. But if y'all want the story time about that, I can definitely do one. But I confronted a bitch recently at school because they were talking shit about me, and I had to let a bitch know, and my nails were long, so I had to get them bitches off real quick just because the bitch wanna get crazy. But as known, bitches ain't stupid, and they didn't want to run hands, so the bitch was shook as fuck. I mean, shook as fuck. You know what the fuck I'm talking about. You know who the fuck I'm talking about. So that's the end of the motherfucking episode, bitch. I hope y'all enjoyed it. Overview of this whole bitch before we even get into the later this season trailer that they did. Sayori cool and she ain't fuck with nobody. She's keeping to herself. New bitch Bree came in and shook shit the fuck up, letting bitches know I'm running shit, giving me boss bitch tease all the way to the max. The creature's still whack as fuck, still a flop. Her mama weave a mess. I mean, she's a mess. I mean, like, but she was doing, she did hook, Speed Bitch up, so I did fuck with her for doing that. Like, bitch, help your friends, but your friends need to help you back because your shit's still fucked up. Definitely not feeling free because she called her a follower. I wouldn't be feeling a bitch either if she called me a follower, so I'm not picking sides between Bree and Seven. You know, I like both of them. Bitch, if a bitch called me a follower, bitch, I'm gonna have to say something, because bitch, I'm not following nobody. Kiki and the creature is going back and forth, like they have it. They gonna fight at some point, like we all know they gonna fight. So they going back and forth, they every day tit for tat at each other's throat. So at some point, this shit gonna butt over, they just gonna get the thumping. Apparently, it's Bree versus Fran, 2 rounds, Say versus Kiki, because Kiki smacked the fuck out of Sayora, but we gonna get to that when it come. Kiki versus Bree. 2 rounds, Kiki versus Kiki, and Bree versus Kiki. So, everybody fought except, oh no, so Seven gonna fight Kiki, so everybody's fighting except Speed Bitch. Speed Bitch learned her lesson not to fight no more bitches, cause we know what happened the first time. Fran just cooling. She don't really got a lot going on. Her, Bree gonna fight at some point over some peace, so we gonna get to that when we get to that. Speedy Bitch. That's it for the fucking video. And thank you. Hope y'all enjoyed it. Follow my social media, my Twitter, my Instagram, my Snapchat for more fuck show on day base. So I'm not gonna see that. I'm a real ass bitch. Give me some suggestions below if you have anything you want to talk about. I just started ram videos, so I go check that bitch out. I fucking tweaked on the upload, but I'm gonna talk about that in the next video. But I fucking tweaked on the upload, so that's why the views ain't up there. But they up there, bitch. They just got deleted because my ass deleted the video and put it back on here. That's the end of the fucking video. And same gang, bitch, we out.